Let it bash. 26th of June, 2018. And I finally got around to getting my new rig up here that I can use my Google Earth. And so I was just playing around with that, and I see, of course, we still have this Pride Month thing going on, right? Pride, and now we're starting to see all the push for the American Pride with the 4th of July coming up, right? Well, it came to me, it's not the first time, but it really came on to me when I saw this, that we are witnessing Satan's rebellion right here. We are bearing witness in these days to the spiritual war that has been raging since the beginning of creation, manifest into our natural world, and you need to recognize that, and you need to turn from it. This is not going away. This is here, and it's real. It's very real, and your eternal soul can depend on it. Governments have given into it. All the major organizations, this is Satan's rebellion. And they bring it in under the guise of love. It's all about love and do what thou wilt. Right? The politicians, the actors, all the liars, all the deceivers. Okay? Disarm hate. Again, it's all about love with this movement, right? Yet, they want to beat the hate out of anyone who disagrees with their lascivious liberty. They are defying nature. They are rebelling against God and nature. You understand? Nature dictates that male and female create the natural marriage, if you will. And they are not wanting that. They want to do what they want and feel good. Because that's what it's all about, your feelings. Governments have all given into it. And the world is glorifying it and lifting it up. Which spells the end of the road. It's only a matter of time before it can't be taken any longer. Because this is really obvious to me. And my spirit testifies that, you know, this is, in fact, the end of days. And, you know, how long those days stretch on, I have no idea. That's not for me to know. But you cannot deny that the things we're seeing, I mean, are really off the hook. The World Council of Churches, all these interfaith groups are all just open arms. Open arms. We all worship the same God, right? This is what they'll tell you. So, I'm looking at the map for the first time in a long time. I haven't had Google for a long time. And here I am in the Northeast, right? And it just hits me. New England, the 13 colonies, right? 13. I've been over 13 so many times I can't even count, but again, rebellion and lawlessness. Nimrod rebelled against God. He just happened to be the 13th in Ham's line, but that's what it is, right? The United States began in New England here, the 13 colonies. And this just is crazy, you guys. I can't wait to show you this stuff, right? What I've marked out here are three major landmarks, right? This is Bunker Hill in Boston. Sorry about the clicking. It's just the way it is with my new little mouse here. But you have Bunker Hill Monument here, which was built soon after the War of Independence to commemorate the Battle of Bunker Hill. And it was built, you know, and funded completely by Masons. It's even got a nice, fancy Masonic Lodge at the base of it. It's 221 feet long. This is all symbolic. It all means something. But I'm not going to get into the numbers right now, okay? But that stands right there. Bunker Hill first freestanding obelisk in the United States. And if I'm not mistaken, at the time it was built, it may have been the tallest obelisk in the world. I may be wrong, but there that is right there. And then, of course, as the colonies grew, Boston was nearly the nation's capital, but it didn't happen. We wound up choosing Washington, D.C., and there's a myriad of reasons for that as well. But if we go down to Washington, let me put in the borders here so I can show you their cube. See this 10 by 10 square here? That's the cube right there, okay? And I'm not going to get into the details of stuff. I just want to show you something on the map that I call Satan's pushpins. These are monuments to Lucifer. They are nothing more than his vanity manifest through men, through the sin of the flesh. That's what it is, okay? And again, we could go over Washington all day long with their unfinished pentagram, the queen bug, all the owls, everything, right? But there's Washington Monument right there. And if we draw a line between Bunker Hill Monument in Boston and the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C., it dissects right through New York City, which is essentially in the middle, right? And remember, this was the center of the colonies. This is the birthplace of the United States. And the United States is the tip of the rebellion. The United States has been made from the beginning, quite literally, to be that catapult, that catalyst, that rebellious engine, I guess you could say. And we see it all over the place. All over the place. I mean, it's undeniable, you guys. Look at this stuff. I mean, seriously, I can't get over it. It's just beyond imagination, quite literally. But here we are. It's on. You need to choose a side is what the bottom line is. But we have this perfectly straight line from the Bunker Hill Monument to the Washington Monument that dissects, and I mean literally dissects through the heart of the beast, Manhattan, New York. Literally straight through the belly, the meat, if you will, of the beast. And these lines here I'm going to show you because they're important, okay? That's that line that runs all the way up from Boston to Washington. Do you know in Central Park in New York, there is another obelisk? This is a very important one. This is probably one of the oldest obelisks in the world, actually. And it's known as Cleopatra's Needle. It sits right in Central Park, right behind the Metropolitan Museum, which we could make a video on in and of itself. Dissects straight through, and New York has a series of prominent, well-known obelisks that run the length of Lower Manhattan here. Again, the meat of this country. This is the I don't want to call it the heart, but you know, it's a black heart. It's the dark heart of America. I mean, between D.C. and never mind. But nonetheless, this is pretty incredible that this line runs straight through there. And probably comes within a half a mile of Cleopatra's Needle, which, you know, Google Earth is subject to a little bit of, being off. But nonetheless, these pins are where these obelisks are. One sits right across the street from the One World Trade Center. Another is right in Midtown, the Worth Obelisk. And of course, we have Cleopatra's Needle. If we draw a line through all of these obelisks, this is really interesting. They all connect throughout the entirety of Manhattan. And what's really wild is right down here, and everyone should recognize this little monument here. Goes literally directly through, maybe by a foot, right? Goes right through the infamous Washington Monument Arch. Okay? Everyone should know this by now. These are just so obvious by now. But isn't it interesting that that line also goes literally through the arch and dissects perfectly with the line from Boston? This is all I'm showing you here is this has been laid out from the beginning. Okay? This has been Satan's plan from the beginning. And everyone has had their opportunity to follow the Word of God, to stay to the Word of God and the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because that's the only thing that'll save you from this coming war that until now has hidden itself, but is now manifesting in the world. And it can't be denied. And this stretch of East Coast here, I believe, is just a matter of time before great, great calamity, you know, befalls this country. It's just the way I see it. This stuff is not by accident. Absolutely not. Over the centuries of Satan's influence to create this rebellion. It's just the way it is. And it's no different in Europe and no different anywhere. But this is pretty amazing to me that what we're seeing just illustrates the literal manifestation of the spiritual war. You can't get around it. The 13, you can't escape this stuff. Why do you think 13? Do you think the 13 colonies were an accident? Do you think? No, absolutely not. And quite frankly, we could do this all day long, you guys. But the bottom line is it's here. And if you don't recognize it, I suggest that you look closer, deep into that pit in your belly that you know something's wrong. You know there is. And there's no guru that's gonna get you out of this. You need a savior. I'm telling you right now. And that's Jesus Christ. It's the only way to escape this darkness that's encompassing this world. So you need to get to know him very soon because it's here. So, yeah, that was interesting to just, we will not rest. There will not rest. The rebellion's here, people. USA. And it's going to kick off soon. We got our Independence Day coming here soon. 242 years. I found that interesting in and of itself. The 24, Jesus, and the 42, the Antichrist. Interesting, huh? So I thought I'd share that stuff with you guys, okay? Seek Jesus diligently, always, and keep looking up, okay? Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.